Hello, this is Jeff at Magical Fruit Toots. In this Photoshop tutorial, we will stylize a map of Huntington Beach, California. For this city, we will use a color-modified white-on-black style. I chose this city because it has an ocean coastline. First, you should create the basic Huntington Beach map using the open-source Tile Mill program and the Mapzen.com Metro Extracts downloads to retrieve the map data files as necessary. For the Huntington Beach shapefiles needed, I used Mapzen Metro Extracts and chose Huntington Beach, California, USA locality. I chose the custom extract in order to have smaller files and quicker processing time in TileMill. I used the sizing handles to extend the area desired some in order to give me more flexibility for cropping later. After receiving the files from Mapzen, I downloaded the OSM2 PGSQL shapefiles. Also, since this city borders the ocean, I downloaded the coastline water shapefiles. Place both files in your project directory. Uncompress them and rename them with a shorter name for the extract folder to help you identify it better. Here are the files in the Huntington OSM PGSQL shapefile folder. And here are the files in the Huntington Water Coastline file. If you have not yet done so, you should view the Photoshop Map Art Basics tutorial on this channel for instructions on how to make the basic map and to export it to a Photoshop PSD file. To make it easier for you, I have placed the Cardo CSS code for the Huntington Beach map in the description area for this tutorial. Make these changes to the basic map code if needed. Open the Layers panel. Add a layer. Browse to the Watercoast shapefile. Select it. Click the Done button. Type Watercoast in the ID field. Then click the Save button. Enter the Watercoast code above the city code block as shown. Press Save. There are two water areas in the Bolsa Chica Ecological Reserve that I think you should include. Add this code above the Watercoast code block as demonstrated. Then click Save. More changes to be made are: large roads line width should be 1.1. Small roads line width should be 0.6. No airport runways were used. Also add the highway equal footway line to the small lines code block as shown. The river's line width should be 1.3. Your city bound code name should be Huntington Beach, as indicated here. Press Save if you've made any changes. Open up the Hunt Begin Photoshop file. To rasterize all layers, press Ctrl-Alt-A to select them. Right-click and choose Rasterize Layer. Select the top layer. You may want to crop your image for easy framing. Open your crop tool set to square with a 1:1 ratio and adjust the crop so the map is centered in the area. Click the big check mark to accept. Now to bring the crop square up to the original 4000 by 4000 pixels that we want. Press Ctrl or Command plus Alt or Option plus I for the Image Size dialog. Change the width to 4000 pixels. The height should automatically change. Rename the bottom layer to City. Make a new layer below the City layer by holding down the Ctrl and the Alt key while clicking the Add New Layer icon at the bottom of the Layers panel. Name the layer Land. Change the foreground color to number 8F6, C0D. Press Alt or Option plus Backspace to fill the land layer with the foreground color. Choose File Save As. Then save the document as Hunt Begin 2. Then immediately save the document as Hunt 1. As we want to have Hunt Begin 2 available in case we need to start over. This map is not meant to be accurate, but an artistic representation. So next we will simplify the city shape. Make the city layer active. Turn off the eye of the streets layer. Zoom in. Notice that some parts of the city have a small strip of land between them and the water. To fix, we will extend the city to the water. Move to the city layer. Control-click the water layer to select it. Inverse the selection. Select a standard hard brush and Alt-click the city to sample the city color. Now start painting the city to cover up the land sticking out. Deselect. Hold down the spacebar and drag to the coastline area of the city. Paint over the Bolsa Rica area. This area is not officially part of the city, but for artistic purposes, we will consider it so. Add a black stroke layer and increase the stroke as shown to see if you missed any areas. If you did, they will appear black. Just paint over them to remove the problem. Then right-click on the effect and choose Clear Layer Styles. Next, to simplify and touch up the water layer, make the water layer active. Use your brush tool. Alt or Option click the water color to load the color. Paint over the problem areas as demonstrated. Next, we will adjust the city boundaries so that they stop at the water. Turn off the eye of the water layer. As you can see, the city boundary extends out into the ocean. Turn back on the eye of the water layer. Now select the city layer. Control-click the water layer. Press Delete to delete the parts of the city that are below the water layer. Deselect. Notice that the land boundary no longer extends beyond the water. Make the streets layer active. Turn on its eye. Add a solid color adjustment layer to it. Choose color number FFE-DD0. To clip it to the streets layer, hold down Alt or Option while hovering the cursor at the bottom of the color fill layer until the downward arrow appears, then click the mouse. Move to the streets layer. Add a layer mask to it. Control-click the city layer. Invert the selection. Choose the gradient tool. Set the foreground to background. With the radial gradient option set, make sure the foreground color is white and the background color is black, and the streets layer mask is still active. Zoom out a little. Then draw a line from about the center of the city to a little beyond the upper right-hand corner of the image, as demonstrated. Let go of the mouse. Deselect. Fit the image to the screen. You may need to adjust for the streets that are bordering but not wholly part of the city proper. The map will look much better if they are included as part of the city. Click the City Streets thumbnail. Control-click the thumbnail to select all the streets. Move to the City Streets mask. Zoom in and use a wet brush to unhide the streets on the edges of the city as demonstrated. Deselect the selection. Next, we will make coloring changes to the layers. Move to the land layer. Add a solid color adjustment layer effect. Make the color number 24221D, an almost black color. I don't like using solid black or solid white, so in this map I used an off-black and an off-white for the colors. Press Ctrl-Alt-G to clip it to the land layer. I used color fill layers in this map as they allow me to easily test color changes of any layer if I wish. If I double-click the color fill layer here, I can test various colors to see the effect. The city layer will be the same color number 24221D as the land layer. To copy the land color fill layer to the city, hold down Alt and drag the land color fill layer above the city. Then let go of the mouse. Press Ctrl-Alt-G to clip it to the city layer. To make a border around the image, select the top layer. Press Shift-Ctrl+N to make a new layer above it. Name it Border. Press Shift+F5 for the Fill dialog. Change the contents to 50% gray. Now add a stroke layer style. Size 24 pixels. Position inside. Click the color box and change the color to number FFEDD0. Now reduce the fill to 0%. Next, to add and style the text, with the top layer active, choose the Text tool. Click the Text color box and use the eyedropper to sample the city black color. Choose your font. I used Magneto. Change the font size to 40 points. Choose the left justify text icon. Place the cursor over the water at the bottom left as demonstrated. Type in Huntington Beach, California, as shown. Open the character panel. If you don't have a character panel, choose Windows, Character. Select the tracking drop-down and select 75. Now change the leading to 42 points. Place the cursor before the C in California and drag over the word California until it is fully selected. Now hover over the tracking VA symbol and drag to the right until the word California is the same width as Huntington Beach. Check the big check mark to accept. Close the character panel. Choose the Move tool. Drag the text to a position on the bottom left where it is about equidistant from the left edge and the bottom edge of the image. Choose the Hand tool to turn off the Move tool. Add a stroke layer style effect to the text. Click the color box and sample the street's off-white color. Make the size 10 and the position outside. Next, to make a custom water layer, move to the water layer. Press Shift-Control plus N to make a layer above the water layer. Name it Water Texture. Press Ctrl-Alt plus G to clip it to the water layer. Since white is your background color, press Ctrl plus Delete to fill it with white. Make the foreground color 0EADAF and the background color 11C5C7. Choose Filter, Render, Fibers. Set Vibrance to 20 and Strength to 10. Choose Edit, Transform, Rotate 90 degrees clockwise. Right-click on a texture layer and choose Convert to Smart Object. Now optionally add a Gaussian Blur. Choose Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. I used a setting of 2.5. Here is the final image. Coming soon, Photoshop Map Art, Metropolis, Illinois, Comic Map Style.